Good morning, students. I am N. Shailaja, PGT Commerce, working in DSMS Midwadi. In today's session, we are going to learn a chapter from 8th class Social Studies. The name of the chapter is Parliament and Central Government. So, our constitution has adopted the parliamentary form of government. Yes? Now, what is this constitution? So, in the previous chapter, you have learned in detail about how the constitution has been made. Yes? It's working. How long time it has taken. The persons related to the constitution, etc. Then, what is this constitution? The constitution is nothing but a set of rules about how the country should be governed. What type of government should be formed. About the rights and duties of the citizens, that's the role of the citizens, and the principles, the directive principles of the state policies, means how the government should rule the nation, etc., etc. So, we have adopted a parliamentary form of government in our constitution with a federal setup. Okay? So, then what is this parliamentary form of government and what is this federal setup? You may ask. So, parliamentary form of government is nothing but the Prime Minister is the real head. The Prime Minister along with his cabinet ministers will rule the country. Yes? Then what is this federal setup? Federal setup means we have a central government and at the state we have state governments and under the state we have different local self-governments. Okay, so this is called federal setup, means the government goes near to the people. Okay, so this is about the federal setup, means at the center we have central government and below that we have state governments at the state level and below that we have local self governments. So, this is called federal setup children. Okay? The government is going near to the people to get the good, like the government policies should reach the people at the right time, at the right place. That's why we have adopted this federal setup. Opposite to the federal setup is unitary government, where only one government rules from the center, that is the central government. Because our country is a vast country, yes, it is divided into different states and we have a huge population, we have adopted a federal setup here. So, parliamentary form of government with a federal setup. Okay? So, that means we have a central government, we have a state government and at the local level, we have a local self-government here. Understood? Now, coming to parliamentary form of government. Parliamentary form of government, the Prime Minister is a real head and his cabinet ministers along with the Prime Minister will rule the nation. Now, how this Prime Minister is elected? So, the people who has attained the voting age, that is earlier it was 21 years, now it has made to 18 years. That is adult franchise. Through adult franchise, these people are elected. Means the people directly who have attained the age of 18 can elect the Prime Minister and his cabinet ministers. So, first let us know how these elections are conducted. Okay? So, through direct elections, means the people from the all over the country. Yes? In the state, they are divided into different constituencies and all. Then, according to the population, the country or the states are divided into different constituencies depending upon the population. So, elections are conducted countrywide and the people elect their representatives from their favorite parties. So, ours is a multi-party system. So, we have many parties and the parties, they nominate their representatives. And the people elect their favorite representatives. And the party which attains 2/3 majority. Okay, the party which attains the 2/3 majority will form the government. And the party which is attaining 2/3 majority will select a leader from among them and he will become the prime minister. And on his advice, the other cabinet ministers are selected. Okay, so this is a parliamentary form of government where the prime minister is a real head and the president is a nominal head. President is the first citizen of the nation. Though he is a head of the nation, he is given only nominal powers. Means he is a namesake head. Understood? He exercises his powers only during the emergencies. Okay, like how we gave due respect for an elderly person in the family, in the similar way we give due respect to the president of our country. He is an elderly person, like an elderly person is a first citizen of the nation. Understood? So this is about the parliamentary form of government. Opposite to this parliamentary form of government is a presidential form of government, where president is a real head. Okay, the ministers, the prime minister and other ministers obey the president orders. He is a real head there. So we can take the example of America. Yes, in presidential form of government, they have adopted the presidential form of government. So recently we have seen recent elections where Joe Biden has become the president of America. Earlier Donald Trump was the president of America. Yes. Now coming to our country India, we have adopted parliamentary form of government. Narendra Modi is the prime minister of our country now. Yes, here president, the nominal head is Ram Nath Kovind. Vice president is Venkaiah Naidu. This is the composition of our government, I'm saying. Okay, so our parliamentary form of government, where the president is a head, who is a nominal head, and under him is a vice president, and under him comes the prime minister and his cabinet minister, and the cabinet ministers and the prime ministers are the real rulers of the country. Okay, so this is a parliamentary form of government. Now what is the role of this parliament? Yes, what is the role of this parliament? Let us see now. So making of laws for the entire country is the most important functions of the parliament. So in the previous class, that is 7th class, you have learnt about how the laws are made in the state. The state legislature makes the laws under the subjects contained in the state list. Okay, so here the parliament, the central government, which is a central government, yes, it makes the laws for the subjects related to the entire country. So making of laws is the most important function of the parliament. Yes, it makes the laws, and so they are so before making it a law, before it is considered as a law, it is called as a bill. So the government will make a bill first. So this bill is passed into the parliament and the parliament approves the bill, then it becomes the law. Okay, so it is not that easy as we are saying it makes the laws and implements. No, so first a bill is made and it is passed in the parliament, then if majority of the people, majority of the members of the parliament approves it, then only it becomes the law. Understood? Now the second point, it also makes policies for the entire country about forests, natural resources, about our relationship with the other countries, etc. Okay, so the states will not make policies or laws regarding these matters. Only the parliament has a power to make policies or laws related to these issues about the natural resources and the relations with other countries, etc. Now coming to the third point, the law relating to money and banking, telephone and postal system is also made by the parliament. Okay, so this is a subject which is under the central list. Okay, these are the all the subjects which are under the central list. The parliament has a power to make laws. Understood? And the fourth important, most important subject is a parliament is defense. Okay, military powers. So regarding how to recruit the military people, where to post them. So this is a very important the function or law which is under the parliament. Understood? So why? Because we have to protect ourselves from the enemy nations. Understood? So this is most important function of the parliament, which has to be done by the central government. Parliament consists of two houses, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. Okay, so these are the two houses of the parliament. Now coming to Lok Sabha. So the members of Lok Sabha are elected directly by the people through adult franchise. Adult franchise means the people who have attained the age of 18 can vote their representatives. So that is called adult franchise. So here the members of Lok Sabha are directly elected by the people, and it has 545 members, and they are called the members of the parliament. And the people who have attained the age of 25 can contest for the members of Lok Sabha. That's why it is called House of Youngsters. Yes, and speaker presides over the meetings of Lok Sabha. If you want to see the meetings and discussions of Lok Sabha, you can watch the Lok Sabha TV channel, children. You can see how the ruling party and opposition parties raise the questions and gives the answers, etc. These discussions you can watch in the Lok Sabha TV clearly. Yes? Then coming to the Rajya Sabha. This is about the Lok Sabha. And coming to the Rajya Sabha, here the members of Rajya Sabha are indirectly elected. They are elected by the state legislatures here. Okay? Then indirectly elected by the people. Yes, because the state legislatures are directly elected by the people, and here the state legislatures are electing the members of Rajya Sabha, and they have 250 members, and they are also called members of the parliament. And the people who have attained the age of 35 can contest for the election to the Rajya Sabha. That is why it's called the House of Elders. And Vice President presides over the meetings of the Rajya Sabha, and is called as ex officio chairman of Rajya Sabha. This is about Rajya Sabha. And here one more thing. The term of office for the Lok Sabha members is 5 years, and the term of office of Rajya Sabha is 6 years, children. And for the every 2 years, 1/3 of its members retire, and elections are conducted for that, for every 2 years, and that 1/3 members are again filled up. So the term of office of the members of Rajya Sabha is 6 years. Understood? Here 5 years and then 6 years. Okay? So these are both the houses of the parliament. And when we compare any policies or bill is passed, most powerful house is the Lok Sabha, because it has more number of members here. So the majority of the people will approve, because from them the ruling party will be there. Yes, and here we have more number of members. So compared to Rajya Sabha, Lok Sabha is a most powerful house, because it has more number of members. And especially when they make budget and money bills are passed into the parliament, Lok Sabha members exercise a supreme power. Yes, so this is about the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. And from among them only the government is formed. The Prime Minister and his cabinet ministers is formed from the ruling party from the Lok Sabha. So this is about the two houses of the parliament. Now student, to sum up, we have learnt about the parliamentary form of government. Yes, constitution we have learnt. The members of Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, that is the two houses of the parliament, and the how the bill becomes the law. Yes, so till here you can learn thoroughly, and this is a very important information which you have to know and learn. So thank you.